Academy, I'm Sarah Price. It's April 6th, and welcome to your 23rd episode of WAtv News. I'm here with...
What's up? It's your boy J-Dog from WAtv. You already know. We have a couple big stories, a couple encouraging messages for everyone entering at the stay-at-home quarantine life period we're in right now. But first, let's get to some stories, and then we'll get to announcements later.
Our first story, I sat down with Gerald Blackmon, an alumni from Wheaton Academy, and I asked him a few questions about his life after high school.
I sat down with 2019 alum Gerald Blackmon. OG was no stranger to the sports or media programs here at WA. From football to basketball to a WAtv anchor, he did it all. Today I asked him how he stays connected to his past in high school while still continuing his future in college.
One of the ways I've stayed connected is really, and yes, like I talk to a lot of the guys that I play sports with at Wheaton Academy. Even over this past year, I've come back and I've spoken with Mrs. Hockett, Mr. Hockett, Coach Fritz, really all people who I know have invested in me and people that I know care about me and are really kind of mentors away from school. And then again, yeah, the friends, I have gone to seeing them. We've all kind of met up during breaks. And really, it's just been an awesome thing because you get so into your college culture just to be able to come back home and still have those relationships and friendships is really awesome. So,
Gerald is currently in his first year at Olivet Nazarene University, pursuing his passion of football. Even though he is in a new season experiencing the college life, I asked him what he misses most about high school.
Something I really, 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 really miss about high school was, and I know like we joke about it, but to be able to come back and talk to my friends after that first semester, really, we just were like, the idea of community was such a true and real thing. Like to be able to just walk down the hallways and say hello to anyone, teachers to say hello to you, be able to see people and to know people care about you. It's just an amazing thing. And it's definitely something that I miss a lot. And then again, I just say the friendships and the relationships that I had, they were real. Some encouragement I have just for the seniors is really to control what you can control. This is definitely a time that is the future is uncertain. Really, it's definitely tough just kind of what has happened in the last couple weeks. But you can control just your grades, your academics, how you finish with when it comes to e-learning. I also think it is important to really kind of invest and do e-learning and finish it well. Even as seniors, I know senior year, you're like, oh, I don't really care. But we don't know what the future holds. So really finish strong. Things are tough. But control what you can control, invest in your family, invest in your academics, invest in the friends, as long as we're able to go out and just finish strong.
Gerald, as a senior, this video spoke to me because obviously your senior year and our senior year is different from each other, but I speak for the seniors when I say thank you for your encouraging words and and helping us stay motivated. And seniors, I pray that we stay strong, we can get through this, and we can actually make it a memorable senior year for the good and not for the bad. So if you guys keep in touch with each other, and we'll make the best of the situation. So,
yeah, Gerald's always really good at, you know, encouraging people and just kind of making the most out of the situation. So I'm praying for you seniors as well. It's different in my year, but praying for you guys.
Anyways, moving on to, we want to give show a story about Mr. Clancy's daughter. Her name is Kerrin Larson. She graduated in 2011. She's a nurse at Lurie's Children's Hospital in Chicago. Mr. Hockett talked to her about being a nurse and what is happening during this unprecedented time.
Hello and welcome to an Alumni Spotlight, where we have former Wheaton Academy students on the show to talk to them about what's happening in their lives right now. I'm your host, Matt Hockett, and today I'm here with Kerrin Larson, formerly Kerrin Clancy, class of 2011, and a nurse at Lurie Children's Hospital of Chicago. Kerrin, thanks for being on the show. Let's talk about the harder stuff right now. Can you explain what's happening at hospitals right now in Chicago? I mean, you're at a children's hospital, so it's a little different, but what's the overall vibe that's going on there?
I would say the biggest thing is kind of like a, honestly, like an overall fear kind of thing, because like we've seen how bad it gets in China. And we see how bad it is in Italy. And we saw Washington and now New York. And it's like, okay, like Chicago's a major city. Like, is it going to get that bad here? But what hospitals are kind of looking like is like a lot of surgeries are being canceled. So like if you have like any kind of elective surgery, it's canceled. So a lot of those recovery units or like the like surgical units are being turned into COVID units. So those rooms and those hospitals and those nurses, those doctors are literally all making this transition into caring for a patient population that they're not used to.
I've been seeing a lot of nurses get on and say, you know what, this isn't what I've signed up for. This is too much for me and my family. Like, I'm putting my own life at risk. They're saying, in essence, there's not enough, what is it called, PPE, right?
Yeah, personal and protective equipment.
We're not, we don't feel protected enough. Do you get a sense that more people are saying this in your world right now?
Oh, absolutely. And I think people are getting angry about it. But one of the things that, because even like Carl was saying, you know, you're at the most risk. And I was like, well, honey, at the same time, like if someone has tuberculosis, like I'm also at the most risk, because who's going to take care of that kid? Yeah. And who's going to take care of like a kid with viral meningitis, something that you can get at college and those kind of things, but like someone still needs to take care of them. I think right now it's in the spotlight and people are very hyped up about it and very like, I didn't sign up for this. And it's very scary. But the thing is, like, I think what they're trying to say is I didn't sign up to work in these conditions.
Yeah.
Meaning like I didn't sign up to do this like without the PPE. So, and I think that's what's got people so on fire, because yes, you are at a little bit more risk, but you also knew that going in, because like you do have to take care of people, whereas like, you know, if you aren't a nurse, you don't have to.
Last question. What's God been teaching you through all of this in the past month? What do you sense him calling you to in your heart? And then how can we pray for you moving forward?
Honestly, God has taught me with this whole COVID situation, things change daily. Like, especially at the hospital, I feel like they're telling us one thing and then the next day it's totally different. So if you don't work for a couple days, it's just, you're kind of blindsided coming in. And with this constant change, I'm just constantly reminded that of Hebrews 13:8, the Lord is the same yesterday, today, tomorrow, and forever. And like how I'm so thankful that with all this scariness, like our hope and our life and our security is not on this earth, because this earth is scary right now.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Larson. Let's get you into the four things you need to know. We want to give a huge shout out to all the doctors and nurses on the front lines of this pandemic. We had a number of people leave comments on our Instagram post. Go check out who people are thankful for. As Dr. Love, father to Britta, states in his comment, social distancing saves lives. There will be way less cases, less family, friends, doctors, nurses, first responders, and all healthcare workers in harm's way. Your decisions affect so many people. Please follow the guidelines and help keep a 6-foot distance from people.
To address the Q&A on our Instagram post at The Real WAtv, the school is saying that because of the nature of the ever-changing events, we cannot make any definitive decisions on prom, graduation, concerts, or other extracurricular activities. Wheaton Academy is, however, committed to doing what is possible, and of course, keeping the students, the number one priority is their safety. So please be on the lookout for decisions to come, but right now we cannot make any definitive decisions, but just keep practicing social distance and keep you and your family safe.
As you start back up with e-learning, remember that you can get many of your questions answered by either checking out the technology tutorial videos in the topics of Student Center or sending a message to Mr. Burek.
Our last four things you need to know, the number four is, we don't have school on Friday because it is Holy Week. However, we will release a special Good Friday chapel service, so please check out that on Friday. And before we wrap it up, we want to show you one more segment, 60 Seconds with Jamal. Go check it out.
Surviving quarantine with Jamal.
Currently, my life during this quarantine has been changing rapidly, with my mom having to go to work for CVS, and her being at risk is honestly something that I am still worrying about, even right now. And otherwise, she could still get paid at the end of the day, but I mean, sometimes I wonder if it's even worth it, really. But otherwise, things are still somewhat the same. My routine thing is still the same. And besides the fact that things are sometimes coming to the door, like we deliver stuff. Like, for instance, my mom ordered some shampoo. So I had to go and put on some rubber gloves and do all this other stuff just so I could, like, make sure that I'm still clean and safe and everything from the coronavirus. And it's just super tedious, but I have to do it. So it's honestly one heck of a struggle for me sometimes because of this. But otherwise, I think it could be better, but yeah.
That's all from us today. Make sure to follow us at The Real WAtv on Instagram and subscribe to our YouTube at WheatonAcademy.org.
Thank you so much for joining us. We are in our studio cribs, you know how it be, but please stay safe out there, and please be reminded that we're going to have YouTube shows every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10:30 a.m. So some of those will be chapels, announcements, even more WAtv segments. Please leave your ideas on Twitter, Instagram, comments below what you'd like us to see. Stay safe. From then out, it's J-Dog and out.